Who are some of the top waiver wire ads for week 4 of the fantasy football season? This video is coming out prior to the Monday night game, so it's definitely subject to change. And I will update it on Tuesday with some more deep waiver wire ads for like deeper leagues. Also defenses to stream and players to keep your eye on throughout the week. So this video will be updated. I make new videos like this every single day, so make sure to hit that subscribe button and also to stay up to date on all the latest content. So with that being said, let's get into the video. The first waiver wire ad for this week, the top priority, is going to be Chuba Hubbard. He needs to be rostered in all leagues right now. We saw on Thursday Night Football, Christian McCaffrey left the game due to a hamstring issue and was ruled out of that game really quickly with the injury. So we had them come out and say Christian McCaffrey is going to miss multiple weeks. So how many weeks exactly, I'm not sure, but I feel like with this injury, they don't want to rush him back. I mean, I'm no doctor or anything, but they don't want to rush him back because it is a soft tissue injury. And I feel like if he comes back a little bit too early, you have the chance of a re-injury. So I think they're going to be a little bit cautious with this. And when Chuba Hubbard came in, he was definitely the guy in this backfield. He's the guy that you want. Royce Freeman in like deeper leagues, I'll possibly add him, but definitely Chuba Hubbard needs to be rostered. He looked like the guy was playing on basically all the downs. You have Royce Freeman come in for a couple of downs, but really he's the guy to have. He's the top waiver wire ad. And if you need running back help, try to go out and get Chuba Hubbard absolutely off waivers. So first player, Chuba Hubbard. The next guy is going to be Emmanuel Sanders. And from here on out, I'm not going in any specific order. It really comes down to what you need on your team. So Emmanuel Sanders right now needs to be rostered in a lot more leagues, though. This is a team that is very pass happy. They're probably the most pass happy team in the NFL right now. And Emmanuel Sanders is running a lot of routes for this team, is playing a lot of the snaps. So Emmanuel Sanders, if you need some wide receiver help, he had a really good game, caught 2 touchdowns this past weekend on 6 targets. Now it's not going to happen every single week, but still a guy that is seeing targets on this offense, is playing a lot of the snaps. He needs to be rostered in a lot more leagues going forward. And if you need wide receiver help, he's a guy that can definitely help you out. So Emmanuel Sanders is the second guy. The next guy is going to be Peyton Barber. And this whole situation makes no sense to me. Like, why go out and pay Kenyon Drake, bring him in, when you just gave Peyton Barber 26 touches? Like, to me, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. But anyways, he definitely needs to be on your fantasy football radar for the Raiders. But he definitely needs to be on your fantasy radar if you have Josh Jacobs out again. Like, his values solely tied to Josh Jacobs missing time. And if Josh Jacobs were to miss this upcoming week, Peyton Barber becomes like honestly startable in fantasy football, because you have the Los Angeles Chargers, who just gave up over 100 rushing yards to CEH the week prior, gave up nearly 200 to the Dallas Cowboys. So Peyton Barber against the Los Angeles Chargers, if you have Josh Jacobs out and he just saw 26 touches, like, yes, he honestly is an RB2 if Josh Jacobs were to miss this upcoming week. So Peyton Barber should be rostered, and we probably won't really know until late in the week if Josh Jacobs is going to play or not. So should be rostered in really all your fantasy leagues, like 10-team, 12-team leagues going forward. Peyton Barber. The next player is going to be Nick Westbrook. And I'm not going to try to say the second part of his last name because I'll butcher it here. But Nick Westbrook led this team in targets and receptions this past weekend with A.J. Brown getting hurt. A.J. Brown got hurt early in this game and was ruled out. He was standing there without his helmet on. I don't know what the severity of his injury is, and we'll probably know in the coming days. And if he misses an extended period of time, then Nick definitely becomes somebody that should be rostered, because once again, he led this team in targets and receptions. And towards the end of the game, you had like Julio not playing. I don't think he's hurt, but he just wasn't playing towards the end of the game, which was a little bit odd in itself. But Nick Westbrook is the next guy. I wouldn't put in a waiver wire claim for him yet. Just see what's going on with AJ Brown, but Nick Westbrook, he's the next guy. Next, there's going to be two guys. We're going to have Brandon Bolden and JJ Taylor. So we have James White leave this game due to a hip injury, and I believe that James White is honestly going to be out for an extended period of time, unfortunately. So one of these guys is going to step in and fill in that James White type of role. So with Brandon Bolden, I believe he's the one that I would probably want the most out of both these guys. He's been with his team for a while. Bill Belichick obviously trusts him, and you had him seeing more touches this past weekend. Now, I want to see what the exact snap percentage was for both these guys this past weekend, but Brandon Bolden right now would be my favorite. But if you don't get him, I would also add like JJ Taylor, and I really wouldn't put in a waiver wire claim for either one of these guys either. I would just wait until they clear, and if one of them clears, pick up one of them. So if you can get one of them as like more of an end of the roster type of spot, I would add one of these guys. But Brandon Bolden is for me the guy that I would prefer out of both of them. So Brandon Bolden and JJ Taylor. The last guy here, once again, this is going to be a shorter list. I'm going to have an updated one on Tuesday. But the last guy is going to be Tyler Conklin. And I hate to say really add a tight end. Like if you're hurting for a tight end right now, Tyler Conklin right now is playing like on majority of the snaps for this team. A team that offensively they're pretty good. And he just had a really solid week this past week. I know last week wasn't the greatest, but the week prior he saw 4 targets, had 4 catches. He's seeing at least 4 targets. He right now is one of the top scoring tight ends of this past weekend. So, hey, I mean, tight end's brutal, but he's a guy, once again, that's playing a lot of snaps on a really good offense. That's all you can hope for. So Tyler Conklin is the last guy. So if you're really desperate at tight end, he's the last guy. So with that being said, if you enjoy this content, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Really appreciate it. Thank you for watching and have a great day.